So as we all know, there's a new coronavirus that's circulating in the world and causing a pandemic across the whole globe. And a lot of people are worried about how can we keep our families safe right here in Missouri. As a parent myself, I am also thinking about these same questions. So far, the one bright spot about COVID-19 appears to be that children do not appear to be very severely affected. It is definitely possible that children are getting this infection and do not have a lot of symptoms and are still spreading to other people, so they may have much more mild symptoms. Most of the strategies to keep your family safe from COVID-19 are actually the same strategies that you follow to keep your family safe from influenza every year. So everyone should be washing their hands a lot, using hand sanitizer a lot. Every time you and your family come back to your house from being out and about, make it a habit to send everyone straight to the sink to wash their hands with soap and water. You can talk to your kid's school and be sure that they have hand sanitizer available for kids at school. And they may also consider having wipes available for kids to wipe down their desks periodically during the day as well. We know kids are not good about not touching their face and not touching anything they want to, so it's important that they keep cleaning their hands frequently. Another important strategy to protect your family and to protect other families is to keep children who are sick at home. So if your kid develops cold symptoms, runny nose, cough, fever, keep them home from school and keep them home from other locations where they might be exposed to lots of other kids or to other adults. COVID-19 infection is still very rare in Missouri right now. So if your child has any of these symptoms, it is more likely that they have influenza or some other respiratory virus. If you are concerned about your child's health, the best thing to do is to call your pediatrician. Don't go straight to your pediatrician's office without calling, because they may want to put in place protections to keep other people in their waiting room and their own staff safe and protected from a possible infection. And don't go straight to the emergency room either, unless your child is having a medical emergency, in which case, of course, go straight to the emergency room. But if you are just worried or have questions or you're not sure what's going on, start with your pediatrician, call them on the phone, and talk to them about what the next best steps are for your child.